games are the latest craze to sweep the country and most of the world, too.
Pac-Man, Ms. Pac-Man, Space Invaders, Defenders, and Asteroids.
Finish him.
I'll be back.
It's alive! It's alive!
Round one.
Okay. Are you afraid of God?
No, I'm afraid of...
Hello, 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 and welcome, boys and girls, to the 70th episode of the Hungry Gamers podcast. We're powered by 8bit.net and Audio Technica. I'm not Tom, host Brendan White. Find me everywhere at Brendan8bit. Joined today, my better half, my worst half, depending on the time of day, Saleem Abraham, who can be found at Saleem Abraham on the Twitters. How you going, brother?
I'm good, man. How you doing?
Yeah, good. There was a bit of a...
Bit of silence there.
Bit of gun shyness on who was taking that intro lead. We probably should have talked about that before we pressed record.
Are we going to go back and record something for that?
We might do.
Or are we just going to let it hang?
We could just let it simmer.
You know, we're afraid of nothing.
Exactly.
Really.
That's
we're quite
exactly
fearless,
where I was thinking. Yeah.
Here on this lovely Sunday afternoon in Sydney. It is so warm today.
It is beautiful.
Such a beautiful day. How are you?
I'm good. It's... You know, what is this, week two of being back here
in reality,
the Southern Hemisphere, back here in Sydney. I've just put pen to paper on a lease on my new place.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I know you've done some similar things the last few weeks as well.
I've had the shittest move-in ever.
Yeah?
Ever.
Do you want to unpack this right now?
Sure. So I've just moved into a place... So it's a big, like, 5-bedroom house. Mm-hmm. I got, like, one of the rooms.
Yeah.
I know the guys who live there already. Like, everyone's great. The room I moved into was, like, shit. So bad, bro.
Very
like,
run down.
Like, the person who'd been in there, this girl, had totally not taken care of anything. It was, like, mold in, bad places. The furniture that was there, all rotten.
So what, she just left things in there? Like, dude, when you moved in, it wasn't an empty room. There was, like, disheveled lounges in there.
So, like, the buddy I'm coordinating it with, like, my new housemate, he was, like, going through what's there. And I was like, all right, well, I'll keep that furniture in there and I'll just use, like, these wardrobes and this bed frame, blah, blah, blah. I get in there and, like, on closer inspection, you can see it's all, like, rotten.
Jesus.
Like, you wouldn't know, it's not on him either, like, you would not know until you, like, open it up.
Yeah.
And obviously, because it was her room until, like, the day before.
Who was to know?
Yeah, who was to know? Yeah, you wouldn't know. So, like, I had to, like, move all the furniture out. I had to, like, we got a cleaner in there. I'm, like, exit molding the shit out of the walls and stuff.
Did you have a, like, sort of that 1960s female house cleaner outfit thing going on,
like a bandana,
jeans, kinda, bandana?
No, not quite. I was just rolling around and I don't know what I was wearing, just old
jocks.
Ratty shit. Yeah.
Yeah,
like stuff that I knew I have to burn afterwards. Like,
fair,
that's cool. How bad this room
fair
was.
Cool.
And it was just like, it was crap because all my stuff's outside the room the whole time, sleeping in the lounge room. It wasn't great. Much better now, thank God. But it took like a solid week of work, man.
And it's
super
like
rough.
That you don't factor in when you move house.
No,
you just think,
get
all my stuff in a day and then I'm settled. It's like, no, mate.
I think I moved in last Sunday. I only had my stuff together yesterday, which is like 6 days, 7 days,
that's,
6 days.
That's still not a bad turnaround. Like,
yeah,
especially
but it's kinda,
considering all this.
And I had to go to like
mold removal.
Yeah. It was pretty tough, man. It's taking some work. But then I like a fun part. I went to like IKEA and I got to like play Sims IRL and like pick out the furniture. Mm-hmm. Like, what's my room gonna look like?
Yeah, I might take you along if you want to come play level 2 because I got to get some more stuff for this
dude,
new place.
I'm in, man. I've had it like in spite of how shit the move's been. Super happy now that everything's settled. Great place, good location too. Like,
yeah, you've
super
out.
Central to everything.
You've lucked out.
Yeah, I'm super happy with how everything's going. I'm on a real high right now, Brendan. I'm on a fucking high.
I will admit that, like, when you rolled in here this afternoon, I have not seen a smile on that face that big since I can't even remember when. It's been too long.
It's like, been good, man.
You're
and
always
I'm just doing...
a very positive guy, but you
I'm
came in today.
Hold on.
And you
don't
were like,
lie. No, I'm very rarely a positive guy.
You were like a Care Bear. You came in here and there's rainbow shooting out your guts. You're like smiling, bouncing around clouds. Like, it was was a sight to behold.
I'm just trying to make it last as long as it can, because by God, it will come crashing down very soon. I know it will. So anyway, I'm sure there's some like knowledge in there for you. Like, you never know what your place is going to look like. Although you've seen your place.
Yeah, already. I've done the inspection, and I don't know why I thought about it, but I actually filmed my walkthrough so I could
really clever. You showed me the video, and I thought, that's fucking smart.
So I can start to visualize where I want to put things, what space I've got, what I don't have to play with. So I got a nice little two-bedder for just me and the pug. So I'll be grabbing Cheddar in a couple of weeks, which is nice to get him in there. We're going to deck that second bedroom out as like our new
Hungry HQ studio. Yeah,
so
man.
We're gonna
super
have...
excited now that I'm all right. So
I feel bad about this.
So like, running joke, but also very true. I'm notoriously late to do the podcast almost every week. It's a big commute. There's no excuse because Ali comes from father.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So I'm like anywhere between 10 to an hour. Sometimes I've been a bit longer, late every
week. Yeah, that's fair.
I now live 20 minutes away from where we do, like literally door to door 20 minutes, and you fucking pick everything up and you move shop to like what will effectively be the same commute that I used to have.
Just keeping on your toes.
You could have it so well. Everyone knows how to get to this place and everyone seems to do it on time. And I'm early like now, you know? Like I could be early. I could be the guy that gets the coffee every week.
We can still work for it. We'll have some discussions offline.
Yeah, maybe like once a month we do it here.
Yeah, yeah. Something like that. Because, yeah, I want to get like a permanent setup where we can have a permanent table in there with the pod gear ready to roll.
Yep.
Permanent video setup, because we're going to start deep dive and pretty heavily into sort of that video space.
Some crazy stuff.
A couple of exciting developments on the back burner that are about ready to go.
Yep, really excited. Really, I think we alluded to a couple of them. Mm-hmm. Hashtag ABC, but we'll get into that later.
Yeah, yeah. So it's going to be a good time. It's going to be a good time.
I'm excited for you, man. It's, dude, nothing like, there's nothing like moving. Like, it just always feels like a new start to.
That's it. It's
the
it's
same
very
story, I guess.
Phoenix rising from the ashes sort of thing.
Yeah. Triumphantly.
Yeah, so it's been a good, just things have just lined up this week really well in regards to this place. Came on the market, I got the application in, because the big thing I wanted a little yard for Mr. Pug, because I don't want him learning life again in like a multi-rise with a little shitty balcony. Like he needs some grass under his little paws.
Yeah.
So that's happened. I've bought a fridge, bought a washing machine already.
Oh wow, so you're already making moves.
Already well making done. Moves. I've well lined done. Up the removalists for Friday to pick up the last of my other stuff, and then get it all in. My taxi box will be there on either the Friday or the Saturday. Unpack that. So I'm next weekend just going to wham, bam, bam. So it's going to be cool.
All systems go. Nice one, man.
Yeah, so that's been happening.
Brendan, tell me about your gaming.
What I've been doing?
Week. What have you been up to? What have you been watching? What have you been playing?
Okay, so maybe we could go with sort of just a couple little throwaways. I've been playing a little bit of Gang Beasts this week.
Right.
Which, you know, PC-based. It's coming to PlayStation 4. I don't know if it's coming to Xbox, but it's sort of a party mode, sort of real simple, you know, combat game where you've got to outlast the other competitors, throw them off the edge or into whatever various objects are in the environment.
Hmm.
I was playing a bit of that online during the week, but I've been pretty limited to what I can play just because all my stuff's in boxes, so it's just been a lot of Switch. So I've been playing a ton of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Had a online tournament with a couple of guys from the Explosion Network, so check them out on the Twitch. They do some podcasts as well. ExplosionNetwork.com I think is their website, but otherwise just /Explosion Network on Twitch. There was like 12 of us just going ham for 3 hours on Mario Kart 8 Deluxe the other day.
Who's top dog?
You're looking at it.
Oh, of course. Of course.
And in my tongue-in-cheek way, I let that be known. I kept screen-capping like the end when they do the award ceremony and you're at the top. And
you're such
just to poke, you know.
You're such a piece of shit.
But then a couple other guys came in and there was, you know, a bit of a power shift. This guy, Idrew, who runs a Nintendo podcast. The name escapes me, so apologies about that if you're listening to this. But yeah, he came in and he was whooping a bit of ass here and there as well. I had a few. I think it ended up maybe
burning a bit of rubber, huh?
Yeah, but it was it's just so fun. Anyone that's got a Switch needs to get on Mario Kart 8. Drop those friend IDs to me because we can get on. And a quick shout out, unrelated to this tournament. I was just playing online randomly and there was this dude And I had to write his name down because he was pissing me off so much.
What?
And his name's Andrew Orr. I'd just like to send out a big fuck you to Andrew Orr because I swear he was hacking. Like, he was just pulling bullshit after bullshit after bullshit every race. So, Andrew Orr, on the off chance you're listening to this, you're a hell of a racer, but fuck you.
But fuck you. Right. Yeah. You know what? On the note of Mario Kart, I saw on one of my feeds this week, this like this funny little thing, a haiku about Mario Kart. Have you seen this?
Is it the... Hey, I won't spoil it.
It's the blue shell one. Yeah, I'll read it out. So it's, are you kidding me? Who the fuck threw the blue shell? I will fuck you up. That's
it's so that's good.
Like, it's like, so good. I was like, that's perfect. That's exactly what everyone says.
Yeah.
Every Mario Kart, like, and every race.
And I was like, not with that artistic structure behind it, but I was saying similar things pretty regularly.
Oh.
Because there was a few times where I'd be so far out in front, just, you know, it's either... You get stuck in the pack and you're just getting smashed all the time. But if you can get a lead, usually pretty good for a while.
So, you know, I actually feel the same way. I'll jump in with what I've been doing because it's not a lot. Tekken, obviously. Mm-hmm. And I make no apologies for it. If you're sick of hearing me talk about Tekken, too bad.
You're the king of Iron Fist. What's it matter?
It's going to be coming very, very often for the next few weeks and months and probably for the rest of this duration of this podcast. So I'm ranked up to now, the rank is called Fighter.
What is
that's
that?
My
what
max
does that
rank.
Mean? Oh, so that's max rank.
No, that's not max rank. Okay. Dude, I'm fucking light years away from max rank.
So what do you start as?
You start as
scrub.
It's hard to explain because you start as like beginner, and then you go like 9th, 8th, 7th, 6th, Kyu, which is like, I think, a karate term, like for like early ranks.
Almost like Dan, sort of, you know, second Dan.
Well, then,
first Dan.
Yeah, then like from first Kyu, you go to first Dan, second Dan, third Dan.
Okay.
Up to like, and then there's just titles at a certain point. You get like, you know, grandmaster and mentor and expert and like all these titles, right? So I've got the title Fighter, which is a fair bit in now. It's like respectable play. Like you at this play, you're not like scrubbing, you're not versing noobs. Like there's no way they'd make it this far. It's pretty tough, man. And like this morning, I think it was the first thing I did today when I woke up. I spent like 2 hours trying to rank up and it was just fucking nuts, man. Like you get so angry. You get so angry, like, playing these games competitively. And that's what made me think of, you know, your Mario Kart and you're losing your shit.
Yeah.
And I'm literally in my living room with the controller standing in front of this TV, not sitting, standing.
Is that because it's just so high tension?
I've got so much energy and, like, I'm, like shaking and wigging out, like, fucking throwing my controller every time. And, like, bullshit, like, walk away. It got to a point where I was like, I had to walk away. I'm saying things that should never be said. Mm. Calling people very horrible things.
People are turning over in their graves.
Yeah, and like at the back of my mind, it's always, I'm shit. Like, I should have fucking blocked that, parried that, got that launch, not whiffed that. I'm just in the back of my head, just losing my mind. Mm. And on that note, hey, YSB.
How did you go? That was last weekend. So York Street Battles, for those that might be just new to this.
This is so much fun.
Sydney-based fighting tourney.
It is so much fun. If you're into like Injustice, Tekken, Street Fighter, Smash, Melee, like, and you enjoy competitive play, Skullgirls, they got like Skullgirls there now, which is also Steam sale like $2 or something. Pick up Skullgirls, such a good fighting game. Dude, YSB, so much fun. It happens every month. You got to get out there. It's in Sydney. If you're close to Sydney, you should do it. I know they've got like BAM in Melbourne as well. Keep an eye out for those things.
That's Battle Arena Melbourne.
That's
for any,
it.
Any new listeners?
And then there's also, I think in September, we've got the Nationals, the Ozhodo Nationals here in Sydney at some kind of ballroom. I don't know.
Let's get along. Let's cover that. Let's get over there.
I'll be there, man.
You'll be there, but let's get over there and we'll film some stuff and we'll make a day of it.
Yeah. So if you're at all interested in competitive fighting games, like, dude, get into this YSB. It's right up your alley. Even if you're not great, that's fine. Super supportive communities. Everyone loves it.
Yeah.
And we had dinner with a friend the other night from Melbourne.
We did.
Jamie Galea.
Shout out to Jamie. The fantastic host at New Game Plus.
Yeah.
Kudos to them as well for getting that second leg. So
yeah, crazy story he was telling us. Yeah. We'll let him maybe tell it another time. But
they're a Melbourne-based outfit. They do a lot on community television, but they're going to pivot now to Twitch and maybe YouTube.
Yep.
They do a lot of really good, well-informed insight on the gaming space.
Mm-hmm.
Give them a spin.
And he's just a great guy. He was down for the Final Fantasy Symphony thing that was happening in Sydney.
Yes.
And Nobuo Uematsu, who is like, you know, just a god in the Final Fantasy world, was here to you know, be there and sit in the audience.
Just hang out.
Just hang out and drive up ticket price.
As it does. As it does. On the topic of viewing, I don't know why, but it's just sunk its hook so deep into me. I've watched American Gods, the series. It's only been out now for just on 3 months. The season just finished a couple of weeks ago. I've watched the season through two and a bit times now just because I'm just loving the universe that's been created with that. It's so fun, and because it's got that typical Brian Fuller artistic style. If you've watched Hannibal, especially, if anyone's watched an episode of Hannibal, the way it's cut and sort of just the real slow-mo artistic sort of pulls with fucking blood splatter and...
Fantastic. Hannibal's amazing. I was so shocked that got cancelled.
Yeah. So there's a lot of that in the shooting style. Tonally, it's very, very different, obviously. It's about the war between the old gods and the new. So, you know, the old Norse gods and the Christian gods versus, you know, the quote-unquote gods that people worship these days, like technology, media, and all that kind of stuff.
So they're... all right, so I've heard mixed reviews. Reviews in progress, obviously, because, like you said, it's just... the season's just wrapped up. But I'm hearing mixed reviews about it. Some of the acting's great, some of it not so good. Very loose comments about, like, the plot seems a little bit off. What did you think? Was it actually like...
I've read the book as well.
Okay. Oh, so it's, I didn't so know it's a book. So it's a book.
I know, I guess, where the story is potentially going.
Yeah.
This first season roughly equates to about a third of the book.
Okay.
So they're already sort of moving things around to so get three plus seasons of this.
Balls deep in the plot is what you're telling me.
They've made a few creative changes, which, as you do, usually from going from... book to television or book to screen. And it works well.
Okay.
I really like it. I really like the casting. Ian McShane as Wednesday. I love Ian McShane. I could sit and watch him just live read the newspaper and I'd be entertained. I just fucking love him as an actor and as a person.
He's great. Yeah, I agree. And he's got so much like on screen charisma. Yeah. And the guy just chooses scenery and everything.
Yeah. And it just seems like there's bits of Al Swearengen in every character he plays. From Deadwood, and there's a bit of that in his portrayal of Wednesday. It's just so fun. It's so different to anything that's on TV. It handles religion and beliefs in a pretty well rounded way. I think it's very respectful.
Okay.
To that kind of
topic. It's sensitive. Sure. Okay. So it doesn't kind of just shit on everyone's religion.
No.
All right. That's nice.
So there is a lot of deeper meaning that a lot of symbology and talking about old gods and the new and how worship has worked over the years and everything. But it's just so good. 8 episodes, you know, just under 8 hours of viewing.
What are you watching it on?
Online.
Is it on Stan or something?
It's not on Stan. You can, I think they've just opened up Amazon Prime here locally now in Australia. Okay. Watch it via there. Otherwise, there is some other outlets that you could get your hands on. It's on Stars.
So I knew that was a loaded question, but because I'd like to definitely check it out.
Yeah. It's great.
So online is the way that we watch it.
It's just different to everything that's on television at the moment.
Okay.
I really like it. And because I've read the book, I'm excited to see where it goes.
Yeah.
Another show that you've started watching too and that I'm fucking all in on is Glow.
Dude, it's amazing.
Yeah.
It is such a good show. So Glow's on Netflix. Mm-hmm. I'm two episodes in. I think maybe, two.
Yeah.
You've seen the whole season,
I've watched
right?
the whole season, yeah.
So I'm just blown away by how good the pilot was. Yeah. It was such a good show. So it's got Alison Brie.
Yep.
What's the name of the other actress who's like kind of the lead as well? It's like they pit them against each other. I forget
Debbie.
Her name.
I can't remember Debbie. Her name in real life. Yeah, I'll vet that right.
Sure,
now.
But it's also got Marc Maron in it, who I did not fucking expect to see in this thing. I had no idea the show was coming. Like it just appeared on my Netflix one day, but it's so good. Maron's so good. He's so funny to watch as this kind of
Betty Gilpin as
Betty
name.
Gilpin. That's it.
Who's actually just in a side part in American Gods.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Oh, there you go. So Glow, Gorgeous Ladies of Wrestling.
Yep.
So it's about the women's the women's league of wrestling in the 80s, and it's all 80s'd up, if that makes sense.
And it's based off a real life documentary. There's actually a real life documentary about this where they tried to set up this league in the 80s.
Yeah.
So there's truth to it, and there's actual real fact in what they're trying to do here.
Yeah, right.
But I love it. Like, I'm...
Oh, it's so fun.
I'm a devout Alison Brie fan. Like, I'm yeah. so smitten on her. Yeah, it's so funny.
We know.
Everyone knows.
Yeah.
So, it's no she secret. Might know. I don't know. Who knows?
She...
I need to scream louder.
She doesn't know.
Damn it.
You need to get in there, man. She's great. She's already married and
yeah,
had a kid or something.
She married... what's his name? God.
The guy from Mad Men, who
no,
she was married to
no,
in Mad
no,
Men.
No, 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 no. Seth Rogen's James...
What?
He's in just all the standard generic comedies. With he's best mate of Seth Rogen.
Oh. Yeah, I know
you're
talking
about.
I'm
having a mental blank of his
surname.
No,
now I am. Franco.
Yeah, his younger brother she married.
Oh.
Yeah.
Buck. Yeah, all right, let's come back to that.
Yeah.
Fuck, what's his name? Why is that?
But you know who I'm talking about.
Yeah, James Franco and... Yeah, I know who you're talking about. He's in 21 Jump Street and like...
Yeah.
Yeah, Superbad and all that stuff.
Yeah.
All right, so anyway. Watch
Glow.
Love
me some Alison Brie.
Yeah, watch
Glow. I love professional wrestling. I love 80s retro.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
it's just packaged into this
it's
fun
obviously
10
in,
episodes.
In the 8-bit aesthetic.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's so good. And there's a couple little professional wrestling cameos. Awesome Kong, who actually plays Welfare Queen. That's not spoiler. That's just one of the characters in the show. She's actually a professional wrestler. Like, she retired from wrestling to try and get into acting. And funnily
really?
Enough, she's got into acting playing a professional wrestler. Oh, want to be a professional wrestler.
Oh, there you go.
That's funny.
Yeah, she's a beast.
She is a beast. So many good one-liners. So many good one-liners.
And it's, you know, it's made by the guys that did Orange is the New Black.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a lot of talent. Like, again, I'm only 2 episodes in, but, you know something's great. 2 yeah. episodes. You know it's going to be great. And yeah, I'm so keen to finish the rest of this. Highly recommend already. Let's cover it off more
yeah,
when
it,
we...
It gets
you know.
My rubber stamp of approval. I
yeah.
loved it. I crammed it all in a day.
Nice.
Just smashed it.
Nice.
Something I wanted to talk about that I haven't been playing this week, but I thought it'd be good to sort of discuss in a little bit more detail that I played at E3 that we didn't really cover off in our 69th episode extravaganza.
Sexy 3.
Sexy 3.
Of course. The infamous Sexy 3.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There's a couple of gag orders on the media, so they don't, you know, disclose too much detail of what happened. But, yeah, it is what it is. Talk to us offline if you want more
Circle
details.
Circle jerks aplenty.
But I thought we'd talk more about Super Mario Odyssey.
Yeah,
it's,
man.
It's won a lot of awards off the back of E3. It won a lot of game of show awards by pretty well every reputable outlet out there.
And you played it.
I played it. I got to play it for about half an hour.
One of the lucky sons mm-hmm. of guns. One of the first in the world who got hands-on experience with Mario Odyssey.
I might have been one of the first at E3 at the very least, because my meeting on the Tuesday was first up in the morning with Nintendo. So
right, okay.
I was straight in there, avoided the queues. Again, shout out to Nintendo AUNZ for allowing that to happen.
And our old pal Kirsty.
That's it. Thank you, Kirsty. Much love. But Super Mario Odyssey.
We're both waiting. Yeah, we're both looking at each other like waiting. Who's going to fucking blink first? All right, so yeah, Mario Odyssey.
Yeah, so I got to play two of the, I guess you could say, tech demos at this stage.
Right, so two levels.
I got to play New Donk City.
Okay.
And Sand Kingdom.
Now, New Donk City was the first kind of look. That's mm-hmm. the stage, the cityscape. Meant to be like New York. You've got people actually walking around.
Correct. And then you're still, you know, 3-foot Mario running around amongst normal civilian life, you could say.
And cabs and shit. Yeah.
Vehicles, shop fronts, restaurants, all that. You literally run around Manhattan. Or
how big is that when you're rolling around in that? How far did you get?
Big world. It's
yeah.
a big world. Like, I got, like, they gave me 15 minutes. Like, the Switch was just pre-configured with this tech demo. You could either finish the level in the 15 minutes, or just after that timer runs out, it just pops up with a thanks for playing screen.
Right, okay.
I didn't finish either of the levels. I got close on both of them, but I was just too busy running around, exploring these very, very distinct universes.
So, all right, so... Because... I didn't play Super Mario 64, but I understand like how that game worked. I'm not a big Mario guy,
actually,
thinking about it. I haven't played too many Marios through and through. What does the end of a level look like in this? I know you said you didn't finish them, but what's the goal you're trying to get to?
Is it another flagpole? No, right. Like not in this one. It was in New Donk City, the mayor, when the demo level opened up, it cut to this mayor of New Donk City
and it was saying, you know, you've got to go talk to her to get your main quest in this
right,
world.
Right, okay.
So you're running around. It doesn't give you... There's no, like, map with an arrow pointing, you know, go this way, turn left, so on and so forth. You just free roam until you find her.
Mm.
I found her, and then the story was... Oh, we're trying to have this big new unveiling, this new exciting exhibit here in the city, but we can't find the band, the live band that was meant to play. So then you're running around trying to find these five band members.
Right.
Like, it's like a brass band.
So it's almost like a Banjo-Kazooie sort of stage,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Ah.
And,
interesting.
You know, the levels are scalable, so it's not just you're running around on a flat plane, you're climbing buildings,
yeah.
you're flying across certain areas.
Is it like very grid-like?
Very grid-like, yeah.
Yeah, it would be, right? Because it's meant to be New York almost.
Correct. Yeah. So you're running around, and something we didn't touch on is Cappy, which is the new addition to the Mario universe.
Yeah. So this is new, right? This isn't like something they're borrowing from another previous...
No, this is brand new. So Cappy is like, from the backstory that the Nintendo reps told me when I was there, he's like some deceased spirit that's possessed this, like, it's almost like a top hat. Right? So that's him in spirit form. He's this little top hat with eyes.
That's not weird at all.
But he inherits the Mario cap, you know, the red plumber hat.
Oh, yeah.
And you can use it not only as a weapon. So
the iconic Mario cap.
Yeah. So you can throw Cappy or the Mario cap out as a weapon, and it sort of spins around like a boomerang. You can long press on it and it'll stand in place.
Yeah, there was footage of this at E3 as well. Mm. Yeah.
Or you can
check this shit out if you're interested online. Yeah. So it's a full weapon now.
Yeah, so it's not only sort of straight in front of you, whip it back, you can sort of curve it, like as in you would in that, what's that movie where they're curving bullets?
Oh, Wanted.
So it's like that. You can throw it and curve it and hit multiple enemies as it comes around.
Like a boomerang almost. Yeah.
You can throw it out and hold the button down and it'll stand in place, and you can use that as like a launch pad, like a jump pad to get to other areas.
And it, like, okay, so it's a spirit that is in the hat.
Yeah.
The spirit lets you also become like frogs and stuff,
correct,
right?
Correct. So you can throw, not only when you're sort of throwing it out and hitting Goombas and stuff like that, you can throw it out to certain objects in the environment, and you can possess, like, you can possess Bullet Bill, you know, the little bullets.
Oh, hate those bastards.
You can possess one of them and sort of skirt around certain areas of the map. You can possess certain, like, light poles, and then you can almost use them as like a springboard to get to other areas. And in New Donk City, you could possess light switches, and then you're attached to some like big circuit line, and so you can use it as a zip line to get up to, you know, maybe high areas or areas across that's unobtainable without this. So,
okay, so
a lot of utility.
It sounds like you got a fair bit out of it. Mm. Do you have obviously, you know, mushrooms and special kind of like power ups that make you shoot fireballs or fly like a flying fox? Like,
I didn't get any of those two levels. I'm assuming there would be to a degree.
Yeah, somehow they'd be implemented.
But in it, you didn't start as sort of like a little Mario and hit a mushroom and sort of size up to normal. It was just, you were the standard 3-foot Mario.
Yeah.
You're running around, but there's, obviously you can get coins. There's, the ongoing thing is there's moons.
Okay.
And you collect these moons, and when you build them up, you get certain bonuses when you finish the level, or it's going to open up other worlds.
Okay.
So you've got to find these moons. But then there's unique currency in each of the worlds as well, from what the Nintendo guys told me and from what I saw. So there was a certain type of coin in New Donk City. Then I went to Sand Kingdom. It was a different type of currency then.
Right.
But yeah, the Sand Kingdom, it looked like, you know, a Day of the Dead type of art style. You know, like Sugar Skull paintings on the characters, like the little NPCs dressed up in like little Sugar Skull paint with guitars on their back and little sombreros and all this.
Yeah, right, okay.
Very vibrant, very bright art style, a lot of pastel, bright colors, purples and yellows and blues, and in amongst this big sort of desert universe.
Mm.
But in that, you could take control of other objects. There was like big, like tiki heads, you know, like the Easter Island heads.
No.
In real life, you know, the big stone heads in Easter Island.
Oh, right, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Yeah, they're in this, and you take control of them, and their ability was like you could press a button, but it'd slow your movement down, but you sort of had like this other world vision, so you could work out where you needed to go to get clues.
Okay.
So you possess him, go do a couple of things to open up further of that side quest, and you can jump back to being Mario to get your way around.
This sounds like really deep for 15 minutes. There's a lot you're unpacking.
Yeah, and the controls, like, that was the the thing that took me a bit to get used to. I started on the motion controls, like on Joy-Con in motion mode, and it was freaking hard.
Oh yeah, was it like satisfying at all?
It was satisfying, but I knew because I was pressed for time. I did that for about 10 minutes, and I said, okay, let's switch back, and I went back to the Pro Controller just so I could
explore
more.
Yeah.
But yeah, the control structure was surprisingly deep, like the jumps as well as how you can utilize Cappy to not only possess things, to get you into certain areas, to use it as a weapon, to, you know, curve it, to have it stationary, to bounce off him to get to areas you can't reach. It's a lot of Mario Sunshine mixed with Mario 64.
Okay.
As far as movement style, control style, graphical aesthetic, very bright. Like it's what you're seeing now in Ukulele, in Banjo-Kazooie, in Mario 64.
It does sound
vibrant, in your face colors.
What you're describing like reminds me a lot of childhood memories playing Banjo-Kazooie. Yeah. Not to say aesthetically it's the same, but just like that same experience. Sounds amazing, man.
Yeah.
So you're obviously, this is a day one fucking pickup.
Oh yeah,
for sure.
I'm super excited for it. It's still got the same theme, you know. Bowser's captured Princess Peach.
Of course.
You're running through Sand Kingdom and there's posters about come to the biggest wedding of the year, and it's, you know, Bowser forcefully marrying Princess Peach and all this, and he's dressed in this big like white pimp suit and things. It's really cool, like the art style. I like it. Like it's a really strong showing for Nintendo.
I was gonna say, yeah, it seems like they're just getting stronger and stronger since the Switch.
Mm.
Like Breath of the Wild was a huge hit. Mario Odyssey sounds like it's gonna be an absolute banger.
Yeah.
Mario Kart, an oldie, but yeah, you said, man, you're having so much fun just rolling around playing just friends.
I think come this holiday period, Switches are just gonna fly off the shelf, because then they've got, as you said, those games you mentioned, plus Mario Rabbids Kingdom Battles, plus some of these other indies.
That game is going to kill, man. Uh-huh. People are going to be talking about Mario vs. Rabbids Kingdom Battle, whatever it is, for fucking ever, man. Because that game looks legit, like a serious tactics game. I keep hearing everyone say it's like XCOM 2. That's great. Like, I hate that comparison, though, because it just seems like so... it reminds me of like literally Final Fantasy Tactics. That's what it looks like to me. And I love that so much, man. I'll play that game for fucking hours.
Mm.
I'll play this game for hours. I need a Switch, man.
You do. And yeah, I think this summer for us, or just let's just say the holiday period, like coming up around that Christmas, it is going to be the thing that everybody wants.
You know,
kids, adults, everything in between. It's going to be moving units, because you can get this massive slew of titles. You'll have Mario, as you said, you'll have Kingdom Battles, you'll have Mario Kart, you'll have Zelda.
Mm.
Those four games alone will see you through for months if you wanted to.
Yeah.
Easy.
Yeah.
So I'm excited. It's good to see Nintendo come out so strong.
Yeah, man. Oh, especially after the last few years. But anyway, let's not, you know, delve on bad things. Hey, happy new financial year.
Oh, yes. Yes. It's the 2nd of July now.
We're now in the 2017-18 financial year for all of you, you know, watching the fiscal calendar.
Mm. So it's weird for me because the company I work for is German based,
right.
So we fall into a different fiscal year. So we do October to September.
Right. Okay.
So we're now just starting Q4, but at the same time, because we've got customers here I deal with in the ANZ market, you get the stress from them leading up to the end of June, where they need to get everything closed off to get their you know, budgets settled and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So we cop it twice.
Yeah, I was gonna say you would. Did you, speaking of copying it twice, not that has anything to do with what I'm about to say
you
next.
You said you weren't going
to
talk about this.
Steam sale, mate. Did you grab anything?
I grabbed a lot of stuff.
Dude, I still need to do it. It ends today. I still need to jump on.
I thought it ended on the 7th because I was going to get some
stuff.
Oh, does it
end on the 7th? I heard July 2. I could have it wrong. Obviously, I haven't looked at it yet. I need to buy shit, bro. There's so many good deals. I heard, so Skullgirls, $2.50. Like Shadow of Mordor. That's
$4.
Them shits is going for $4. That's crazy, $4. Bro. That's fucking crazy, man. And there's like hundreds of other games. I'm so excited to do this when I finish here.
Yeah, I've probably put in, I think it was about 150 US. So maybe let's say $200.
Yeah.
But in that, I got maybe 50 games.
Yeah. So they would all be bangers too.
Yes.
You wouldn't play half of them.
No.
I guarantee you.
I intend to one day.
Yeah.
But yeah. But a few things you mentioned, like
Skullgirls, Shadow of Mordor. What, there's don't worry.
Like things like City Skylines, which is, that's like $12.
I'm buying that.
I bought a couple of Devolver digital packs where I got like 20 games for about $25. Perception, the Bioshock collection. I bought Bioshock 1, 2, and 3 remastered.
I was going to say, the games, do you have those games already?
I do, but I haven't got them remastered. $14.
Okay.
All three of them.
Yeah.
Which is fantastic.
Can't pass up a bargain, right?
I got Perception for $22. So many.
Yeah.
So many goddamn games out there. Portal 1 and Portal 2 together was $2.50.
Yeah, right. Yeah, dude. So that's great. I'm going to do that. Yeah, I was just thinking last week we were talking about the EB Games deal in Australia. $20 for Crash Bandicoot if you trade in two games. So I did not believe the shit you two were saying about like it could be anything. So I went into EB and I asked the guy, and he straight up said, "Yeah, that's fine. Maybe don't do it on the same day at the same store, but yeah, like there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, told
you can." So the thing is, if you give them two games of any condition, as long as it's Xbox One, PS4,
or Switch,
they'll take it. They'll take it. So I was like, all right, so if I buy two pre-owned games from here for $8 each, can I use them? And he's like, yeah, no worries. I was like, how are you making money off this? He goes, probably we're not. I really appreciated the honesty. I will not say this guy's name or which store I went to, because EB is savage.
Mm-hmm.
Savage to their employees. But fantastic deal. Guys, pick up Crash. Have you played it?
I've got it. I've finished one and I've nearly finished two.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Dude, I've got to get it.
It's so good. The first one, the original Crash, some of the controls are pretty frustrating. And I haven't gone back and played the original to have a direct comparison to see if it was like that back then too.
Yeah.
But the second one is certainly the strongest out of the two I've played. I haven't touched the third
yet. Yeah, the second one's where you start going like on water, like jet skis and shit, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then the boss battles.
Vehicle combat and stuff like that.
So. Yeah. No, I love the first one, but the second one, I think, I agree, it's stronger.
Yeah. Get your hands on it, because I'd like to talk about those in more detail, maybe in the coming weeks, but it's getting sold out everywhere.
Yeah, it's huge.
I'm seeing it online, and I was walking through the city yesterday, and I popped into JB and then EB just to see what's going on.
Yeah.
Both of them sold out in George Street there. Both of them were sold out. And then I was seeing people post online, can't get it to this store, that store. I don't know if they just had like a small run, just underestimating, or if it is just selling like
gangbusters. It's reasonably priced, man. $50.
Yeah.
And like they're not short games. Like you can get stuck on, from memory, like you can get stuck on one for a while.
Mm.
Yeah, they're so good.
Yeah. And it's funny, on that EB hustle story you just mentioned, if you don't take in your own two games, when I was in the EB in the city, I was sort of just buying a couple of other bits and pieces, but the person in front wanted to buy Crash, and they said, "Oh, can you price match Target at $49? And the girl at the counter said, "No, we can't, but we can do one better, and we can do it for you for $35. And then she did this whole spiel where she's like, "I'll sell you two copies of Watch Dogs, and then we'll return them in, and then you get it for $35. So even they're doing pseudo insider trading.
So they're on, are they?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, that's so good.
Yeah, but get on it. Like, even if you can't get a deal and it's just $60 for three games.
Three good games.
Three fantastic platformers. Do it.
All right, I'll do it this week, and we can talk about it next week. How about that?
For sure.
How about that?
For sure.
All right.
For sure. Okay, so should we dive into a bit of the news?
I think so. Let's do it.
This week's news headlines.
Okay, so the first bit of news doing the rounds is the standalone Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered edition has been confirmed. Available now, which is insane. Like, they leaked this news and then they said, "Oh, by the way, it's available this coming week."
Yeah.
So it's the full base campaign, 16 multiplayer maps. I spent a lot of time, and I know you played a lot of original Modern Warfare.
Back in like the internet cafe days, this game would just run. You'd play multiplayer lands all day.
Yeah,
it was fantastic.
6v6 local lands.
Yeah, shipment fucking all day.
Yeah, just shotguns.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we knew this was going to happen eventually, right? It was tied in with the last Call of Duty game. And we called it out. I mean, everyone knew this would happen. It's just such a great game.
Yeah, we knew it was happening. But the one thing that sort of gets up my goat is they're trying to charge $70.
$70, yeah. It's ridiculous, isn't it? Yeah. And also, it's a bit shit. It's coming out, if you look at like the Call of Duty release cycles, We're like, what, 2 months away from another Call of Duty at this stage?
Yeah, three months. But still, it's impending.
Yeah, it's coming. I don't know. I'm definitely not picking this up as much as I loved it. I just think, you know, it's a relic of the past for me now. There's other games to be played.
On the talk of that hustle, you can actually buy Infinite Warfare with the Modern Warfare edition of Infinite Warfare. I think it's like Legendary or whatever they call it. You can get it cheaper than buying this.
You're
standalone.
Kidding.
So you could buy the two.
You're joking. It's pre-owned?
You'll have to download it digitally, but you can buy the two.
Holy shit.
For cheaper.
Oh, well, there you go. So don't even bother with this. Buy both if you're going to buy it. But who wants to play Infinite Warfare anyway?
Yeah, I haven't touched the multiplayer, but I really enjoyed the single player campaign. You know,
yeah.
We talked
oh,
about
they're
this
always good.
Prior episode. Yeah. But yeah, so that was interesting. Another thing that I'm like about that got dropped this week was the trailer for the new Jumanji film.
Dude, you didn't like it, did you?
Not really.
I fucking loved it. I ate that shit up. That was like, I was because it's crazy. Like it's not Jumanji that we know.
No.
At all. No. Like they're playing fucking video games now.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, I'm with you.
Yeah.
And then they all go into the game and they become famous people. like one of them's The Rock, one of them's Kevin Hart,
one of them's
Jack Black, and the other one.
Yeah, but they don't become the famous
people.
Actress? They're the avatars.
Yeah, they're the avatars.
Yeah.
But they are. Like their personality, like the nerd boy is now like The Rock.
Yeah.
And so you've got that obvious conflict
and
of like, oh, how do I be that?
The vain cute blonde high school girl becomes Jack Black, which I found very funny.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's interesting. Like, so you watch the trailer and these people are in detention.
You've got
some bloody Breakfast Club vibes going here. They're in detention.
Oh, serious Breakfast Club vibes.
They're cleaning out this, I'm guessing it's like an unused AV room.
Yeah.
And he pulls out this Atari-looking console, and they're like, oh, let's play.
Which is nothing, right? It's a nothing console.
So it's this Jumanji console. They plug it into an old CRT television. Graphics are popping on this thing, by the way. No fucking way. They could have at least made it, like, that's one of my annoyances. They should have made this, like, 8-bit sort of pixel start screens. Instead, they got, like, 1080p, 60 frames rolling.
But fuck it. Just go with it. Like, don't really into it too much. And, you know, I'll
watch anything The Rock's in because I just love the
dude. Oh, he's great. Yeah.
You know, anything he touches turns to gold.
It actually looks like Tropic Thunder, like the film they were trying to make in Tropic Thunder. Yeah. That's what this looks like.
I'm hoping there's a fat Tom Cruise cameo in here somewhere dancing. Remember
that in Tropic Thunder? Oh, so good. Yeah. I don't hate this, man. This will be fun. This will be a fun film.
Yeah, it'll be a fun popcorn film, and it's coming out over the Christmas period.
Yeah.
So it'll be, you know, that school, very smart, that school holiday period.
Yeah.
Parents and their kids are going to flock to this.
And Kevin Hart and The Rock are just such a good combo, man.
I love them in Central Intelligence together.
Yeah.
Have you watched that?
No.
Well worth a watch.
Dude.
Well worth a watch. Had me in stitches.
Too funny. Anyway. What else we got?
I don't know if we want to dive too heavily into it just because you haven't watched it. Maybe it's something we could probably unpack later.
The Beyond Good and Evil 2 tech demo.
Yeah. So this is one thing. It took me by surprise that they've dropped. So it's an 11-minute demo of the game. I know last week I panned this a little bit where I just said, come out here, and then when they're like, help us make this game, help us build this universe. And I thought it was sort of a pseudo Kickstarter, like GoFundMe.
Yeah, which can I just call this out? I thought you were like fucking off your rocker, like thinking that. Like, of course they're not asking for money.
Shenmue?
I think they're just trying to build a... Yeah, shit. Well, they at least asked for money. Like, if you're going to ask for money, you have to ask.
Yeah.
They just want to build a community, but they have a tech demo.
Yeah, so it's like a 14-minute tech demo. Michael Ansel's taken us through it. In-game engine. The universe looks great. Like, obviously, there's that false polish, I guess you could say, with the tech demo. That obviously, they want to put their best foot forward.
Oh, yeah. It's all CG.
But the sense of scale that they show in this blew me away.
Blew me away. Right.
And yeah, I know I probably unnecessarily sort of took a bit of a shot at them when I thought they were going down the GoFundMe route. So I apologize. Apologize to everyone involved in that, to Ubisoft
and
you.
Okay, thank you. Apology accepted.
Thanks, man. Thanks. But it looks so good. Just showing the sense of scale going from your main sort of cruiser spaceship to sort of your little small one where you can nip around missions. They're sort of breaching into orbit, watching sort of the fire trails off the Starcraft, just the depth of field on the view as well. They're cruising around this this planet, and then they just go straight into orbit, and then start like he's sort of circling other planets. Like, it looks great. I'm a big sci-fi nut, and if this is sort of more like a more lighthearted Mass Effect in a way, because there is RPG elements, there's character customization in it.
Can I just jump in really quickly on you being a sci-fi nut? Happy 20th anniversary, Fifth Element.
Yes,
happened this week, didn't it?
Yes. Yeah. We should organize a session to
fucking
watch that.
Great
again.
Film, man. Love that. Anyway, sorry, go on.
But it's well worth your time. Like, head over to the Ubisoft YouTube channel. It's 14 minutes. They talk. Yeah, Michael Ansel's talking through it as he's playing. It's great. It is making me a pretty excited.
Pretty happy chappy.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And you can obviously still sign up to the Space Monkey program, which is the where they were the help us build it, quote unquote, from
it's
E3.
Community thing they want to do. I want to see this because I wasn't too impressed really with the E3 trailer that we
just
saw.
With the CGI trailer.
It is gorgeous. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying it's not gorgeous. It just it might even be a great game. It doesn't seem like my game is my comment, I guess, I'm making. Yeah. I'm not criticizing what they're doing. I'm just saying
it's not
appealing to me.
Yeah, yeah.
Like it literally looked like an Overwatch trailer where everyone got to swear, and it was so hammy. It was so fucking hammy, and that ape. Like, I just want to punch that ape in the face, bro. Yeah.
He was like the ape version of God, fuck. My brain is just not working today.
Tracer, Cavalry here.
Yeah,
like,
a bit of that.
And it was just, yeah, I don't know. I'm not sold on it. I'll see the tech demo though. Like, I'm open.
Yeah,
but
give it a watch because I'd love to get your feedback.
Okay.
A bit more feedback I'd be seeking is, you know, the rumor that's been doing the rounds the last month or two, the SNES Classic Mini.
This is all but confirmed, bro.
I know. But it didn't get announced at E3, and I like that. I like that they didn't take any sort of shine off Mario plus Rabbids or Mario Odyssey or Metroid Prime 4 and everything else. So the SNES Classic Mini has been announced. It's going to be available from September the 30th, and no doubt probably for some of the other regions in the globe, but at least for Australia, New Zealand, it is currently sold the fuck out. So angry. Pre-orders went on sale.
And they said too that there would be a larger number of consoles available.
Yeah.
Fuck yourself. Why is this so hard? I want this so bad. Let's talk about some of the games on this thing.
For sure.
Earthbound, Final Fantasy 3, Kirby Superstar, Legend of Zelda Link to the Past, Mega Man X, Star Fox 1, Star Fox 2, which never got released. Street Fighter 2 Turbo, you got Super Mario Kart, the first Super Mario Kart. You've got Super Mario World, you've got Super Metroid, Yoshi's Island. And more. Like, there's more games there.
This is the who's who of the SNES.
Oh, my God.
All that's missing is Donkey Kong Country 2 and Chrono Trigger.
Kong Country's there. Yeah, oh, not too. But, like, it's just, fuck. Like, why can't I get this for less than $500 from some scalp?
So they went on sale $119.95 with the 21 games. I've pre-ordered two of them.
Oh, so you're one of the guys.
I've got two. But I'm going to give one away. We're going to give one away on the show.
Oh, fuck. Can you give it to me, bro?
Maybe I'll give you the other one.
I'll do more work, I promise. Mm. If I do a bit more around the house, will you let me let me have a SNES?
You do your chores.
I'll buy it off you. Like, I'll buy it off you at retail price.
Yeah.
You know,
retail price.
Don't mark it up.
I could make some more on gum. No, but I...
wouldn't surprise me.
Because EB and JB here in Australia had them go on sale. So I went to both shop fronts online, just went whack, whack.
Is it one each? Was it one each?
Maximum one per customer. Hence why I went to two different channels.
Good. Yeah, yeah.
I'd say they'll probably have a couple more really small... Limited stock runs coming through.
They did that with obviously
with the NES. But this is great. Like,
to everyone's frustration too, like long after everyone had bought from the scalpers, stupid inflated prices.
So that was horribly
managed.
Comes with two controllers. The leads are longer. They're 2 feet.
I was
going to
say, do we know?
So they're two feet longer, which is fucking sweet.
On board.
Obviously, it doesn't come with the power adapter, but you don't need it because you can run it off USB, off your TV, off your computer.
Crazy.
You know, minimal power draw. So anyone out there that's sort of up in arms about having to pony up another $20 for the power converter, don't worry about it. Just USB it off your television. That's going to run it. But this is the who's who of the SNES. Like, as you said, that roster of games is everyone's childhood.
It's
from the 90s.
It's so good.
I'm super, super excited.
I'm so glad you've got two of these things.
Yeah.
Okay, so potentially giveaway down the line, folks.
We're going to give one away for sure. The second one, we'll confirm what we're going to do with it at a later date. But at the very least, anyone that did miss out on the SNES Classic Mini, you'll be able to win one here. So stay tuned for that.
Very cool.
But I'm so excited to play, like, even just like Castlevania 4. Getting back into Super Metroid. Yoshi's Island. Very underrated game. So much fun.
I'm just thinking of how I can, like, thriftily get one of these. Get my hands on one of these.
It'll open up again.
Yeah.
It'll open up again.
Yeah, I'm just going to have to wait.
Yeah, give it time. There'll be another rush.
Like an October release.
If I see it first, if I see another online thing first and I can get one.
Dude,
I'll do it and then I'll leave.
All right, thanks, man. Thanks.
So another little bit of news. It's just a little bit of a throwaway, but the original R2-D2 sold at auction this week for $2.75 million.
This is the original R2-D2 costume. For $2.75 million, where's that money going? Is it just going to private?
It's private? Gone to private. Yeah, it's sold off an estate from its deceased owner, so I don't know where it's going from there. The one that surprised
me... I forget the actor's name, but he passed away, I want to say, this year or last year, right?
Yeah, last year. The little...
Yeah, the guy who was in there.
I can't remember his name now.
I'm going to Google it. But you Google is it that. His estate that it came from?
I don't think so. I think this was like from a previous collector.
Oh, right. So he already made a buck?
Yeah, so the owner was looking for $2 million, and he got well above that. They also sold... Luke Skywalker, aka Mark Hamill's lightsaber from the original Star Wars and The Empire Strikes Back. And that sold for, I know only is a bit of a loose term, but only $390,000.
Comparatively, yeah.
Yeah, I thought the lightsaber would have more, like R2-D2 is an icon.
Yeah.
But the lightsaber.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah.
You know?
That's crazy.
That's the lightsaber not only of Luke Skywalker, but also of Anakin Skywalker, aka young Darth Vader.
Yeah.
Killed a lot of our younglings with that lightsaber.
And now Rey. Now it's with Rey.
Yeah. I thought that would go for a lot more. But anyway, I thought that was pretty cool. But yeah, the identity of the buyers is unknown. So there's no sort of word if this might go into a museum or whatnot. I think it's just going to be on his shelf in his man or woman cave of the he-she collector.
Oh, it is going to the... biggest nerd, bro.
Yeah,
absolutely, man. Mm-hmm. And power to him. Congratulations on your new lightsaber.
Yeah, $390,000. It'd be nuts. Nice to have the amount of money to just do that. You know, like, oh, what's going on this week? Oh, yeah, I'll buy the original Darth Vader voice box. You know, he's $500,000. But anyway, that's the news this week.
There's
I
was going to say, there's a little something special we're going
to
do now.
There is a little something special. We're going to roll out a new segment, which we call...
This Week in Gaming.
And so what this is a weekly segment where we're going to look at the calendar week leading up to this episode and see any big releases, any big bits of news, anything worth talking
any
about.
Any significant moments in history, Brendan.
Yes, yes. So... this week, I've grabbed a handful of news headlines over the years. Going back to the year 2000, a game some of you may or may not have played on the original Sony PlayStation, but this week in the year 2000, Wu-Tang Shaolin Style was released. Did you ever play this game?
No, I didn't. I didn't. But I love it.
It was hot off the peaks of the Wu-Tang rap crew.
Yeah,
you could take control of Ghostface Killer and the RZA and all these guys, and they're now all martial arts superstars. Fighting game, surprisingly gory. You know, you could do like not fatalities. I can't remember what they called them in there, but it was interesting. I spent a bit of time playing that. Another game that came out this week in the year 2004, Spider-Man 2.
Huge. Huge. Mm-hmm. And especially after the back of E3, off the back of E3 and seeing new Spider-Man and how similar it is.
Mm-hmm.
What a game.
Yeah.
That is like the pinnacle of...
Spider-Man gaming.
Of Spider-Man gaming. But it was just, I don't know, I think it was very ahead of its time.
It's probably almost the pinnacle of Marvel franchise-based games almost to this day.
What
still.
Else is there, really? I mean, you're taking into account as well, like, Marvel vs. Capcom games and stuff.
Oh, like, ignore them. Like, more so the action-adventure, like, this style.
Yeah.
The only other one that comes to mind, which I really liked, was the Wolverine game.
The Weapon X one?
Yeah, X-Men Origins Wolverine or whatever it was called.
Right.
Came out a few years ago off the back of the film. Film was absolute dog shit, but the game was great. Really gory. Yeah.
That film sucked.
Running around
that film
as,
was awful.
Yeah, running around as Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, just slicing guys up. Like, it was visceral. Like, people are getting dismembered. You're getting shot at and you can sort of see the bullets hit you and, you know, exposing your flesh, but then your regeneration abilities in there, so you're watching yourself heal on the fly. Mm. Really fun game. Really fun game.
Nice.
Hey,
that film's out next week, isn't it? July 7? Is that when it's out?
Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that it? July 7?
Which is annoying because it's already out in America. Usually, we're usually the week early on these big ones with them for the most part.
Oh, we lose sometimes.
And we lost because I wanted to watch it this weekend.
Yeah.
But it's out this coming Thursday.
Cannot wait. It actually looks good.
It's getting some good reviews. It's like 92% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Well, we can talk about that in a moment.
Yeah. Yeah. Which leads nicely into this next bit of week in gaming news. Also in 2004, IGN acquired Rotten Tomatoes.
Yeah. Nice little bit of news there.
13 years later. And a little throwaway, just as a little subtle nod to our alley over in San Diego. She's probably got this game. In 2007, Big Tits at the Beach was released on Newgrounds.com.
What the fuck is that game? What is that game? Big Tits at the Beach.
I have not. But remember Newgrounds? It was just like...
Oh, yeah. I remember Newgrounds.
HTML-based games.
It was like any sort of flash nudity you could think of, it would be there. Ali, when you're back, tell us about Big Tits at the Beach.
Maybe we need to do some digging and try and play that this week. See if it's any good.
Sure. I'm sure it is.
Is Newgrounds.com still a website?
I think it is. You're going to go there now, eh?
Yeah.
Check
it
out.
Just to see if it loads. Let's see.
I haven't been there in years, man.
It's still a site.
There you go.
There's a lot
of
games.
That was where, like, teenage me went to go and find, like, nude things.
Mm-hmm.
And I frothed it. Loved it. A lot of dating simulators
on
there.
One of the first games on here is called To Goof a Predator, and you've got to prank sex predators.
Wow.
That's heavy. Anyway.
Okay. All right.
That's a story for another day.
Yeah.
So that is the first installment of the week in gaming. I think it's pretty cool to look back and
this week in gaming or the week in gaming
this week. Oh, sorry, it's new. I'm working on it.
It's fine.
Whatever our soundbite said. So new releases this week. I haven't put them in there. Whoops.
Neither have I, but that's all right. We've got Until Dawn, which is free with PS Plus.
Yeah, that's the only thing. I think I didn't put them in there because I thought this is the only thing that matters this week. So
it kind of is.
PlayStation Plus, Until Dawn is free for PS Plus members. If you're not a member, sign up right now. Pay your $7 or whatever for this month. Download this game, then cancel it. Who cares? Just get a copy of Until Dawn because it is so, so good.
It's a good party game. So I had I've had a couple of friends get together and just assume the role of characters. Mm. And literally whichever character is playable at the time, it switches to them and they make decisions based on that,
so
like
good.
What they would do. And it's so much fun. Like, yeah, I am picking this up. Obviously, it's free.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe I'll like find some time outside of Tekken to play it. Maybe
I want to go through and do another playthrough. I jump on this game probably once every, I don't know, 6 to 9 months, because you can depend on obviously how much time you've got available. You could play through in one sitting.
Mm.
Otherwise, two. But it's just campy slasher horror movie fun. The goddamn Wendigo spirit demon things are terrifying.
Yeah.
And they always seem to fuck me up. That last scene with Hayden Panettiere in it, I'm always ruining it. But I'm excited to go back into it and play. And all you PlayStation listeners can play free right now. So get on it. There's some other games on the list as well for PlayStation Plus members this month. But that is the only thing I wanted to bring attention to. Another thing that's going on this week in regards to game deals.
Mm-hmm.
Xbox, if you are a gold member especially, you can get yourself some pretty hefty savings in the quote-unquote ultimate game sale. So you can get Injustice 2 at the moment. If you're not a gold member, 15% off. If you are a gold member, 25% off.
Pretty solid.
Ghost Recon, 35% off. Mass Effect Andromeda, half price. Elder Scrolls Morrowind, 35% off. For Honor, 40% off. Battlefield 1, 60% off.
Fuck, yeah, some big savings, man.
Yeah, they're just a few of the titles. I think there's about 70-plus games available on sale, but they're the main big ones. And the last event that's going on this week that we will be taking part in and filming our experience is Zed Town. So
yeah, so I said yes to this, and then I just completely forgot we're doing it. When is this, Saturday or Sunday?
Next Saturday.
Okay,
next
and this
Saturday,
is like the zombie shootout.
Yeah, 11 to 4.
Next Saturday, 11 till 4.
Yeah, so...
Do I need to sign up? Have I signed up already?
I've already signed you up. Oh, okay. We've already got our tickets. We're good.
I'm glad we do all of this like back of house business while we're doing the show. It's really good. Sorry, mate.
So you don't have to stress. You don't have to stress.
Yeah.
So any Sydney-based people that are fans of Walking Dead or zombies in general or just want to get out and be active this coming Saturday, head over to the Zedtown website or check out Zedtown on Facebook. Tickets are still available. You've got to bring your own Nerf blaster, so you've got to bring your own Nerf gun.
So I've got to find me some Nerf guns.
We'll get that sorted this week because we're going full costume and we're going to get...
Are we?
Like, we're just going to buy some cheapy imitation GoPros and we're going to strap them to ourselves. We're all going to get full cameras of the experience and we're going to slice this up into a cool video.
Holy shit.
So we're going all in, man.
All right, I'm in.
But
I'm so in.
Yeah, so it's like a 4-hour experience at the Sydney Showground. Huge, huge location.
Yeah.
Starts with a handful of zombies. They're chasing you around. You shoot them. They're obviously dead instead of just undead. But if they get you, then you are out or you become a zombie. They've actually got makeup artists all around the place too. So if you get attacked, you can go over to them and they can kit you out looking like a zombie as well. It's a whole thing.
I'm so keen.
It's going to be super fun.
It sounds great. I'm going to fuck some zombies
up. Yeah, I'm super excited. I'm also... Excited you know, to see how long until the betrayal starts.
Oh, dude, I'm betraying you. Amongst the three of us. You and Reese, dead, bro. Mm. You're dead to me from the word go. Mm. Trust me. Don't turn your back.
See, I'm confident because I think we're a bit more agile than young Reese. So if a swarm's coming at us, I'm just like pushing him over and running the other way.
Oh, man. I'm so keen for this. All right. So stay tuned for that. That's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Full recap coming on the YouTube as well as the podcast. So
yeah, we'll do the podcast Sunday next week.
It's going to be awesome. It's going to be so awesome. And something else that's awesome is our last segment for the podcast.
iTunes Review of the Week.
Do you like that I haven't ruined any of the sound bites in this episode? I've been really good, man. I'm learning.
It's because you're this positive care bear, remember?
That's what I'm trying to be.
Shooting rainbows.
Shooting rainbows everywhere.
So this
Dave
one...
Dave Chappelle's got a good joke about Care Bears in his latest Netflix thing.
Really?
Have you
got it? Like the joke handy?
The joke is like he talks about how Care Bears was this really positive thing and they'd shoot love out of their chest and in real life you can't do that, and then he kind of throws away. He goes, yeah, but I have shot love onto someone's chest before.
Yeehaw.
Yeah, yeehaw.
Yeah.
Sorry if you've got kids in the room.
Mm.
Sorry about that. I should have... Anyway, we've been swearing all episode. We're an R18 episode. Podcast.
That's it.
Yeah. Mm. And we make no apologies
for
that.
The kids grow up quick listening to this show.
Yeah. We'll make a man out of your boy.
Mommy, how do I get shot on the chest?
Yeah. Oh, God. All right.
Go eat your vegetables.
That's so bad. Let's not unpack that. All right.
Okay. So, our iTunes review of the week gives us the headline, hashtag stay hungry, which is a thing. Use that in all our posts to us. Giving us that tasty 5 stars by someone or 2 people. I'm not too sure. But the user is A Couple of NPCs. And the review reads, Australian Gaming Podcast? ? They did those over there? ? All jokes aside, the Hungry Gamers bring nothing but quality when it comes to information, banter, and laughs. Keep up the good work. Next round is on you, Winky Face. Totally not A Couple of NPCs.
Thank you very much, boys. Obviously, friends of the podcast, A Couple of NPCs who have their own podcast,
which is A Couple of NPCs,
which is called A Couple of NPCs.
Andrew, Alex.
Andrew's celebrating his birthday yesterday.
Yeah,
not sure of the age, but he got a Switch. The lucky
bastard. I'm pretty sure he turned 28.
28, yeah,
28 or 29. It was one of those, and now I feel bad for not remembering.
Happy birthday, and thank you very much for the lovely review. I think we've responded in kind.
We need to if we haven't.
I have, definitely. But the problem is, and fellas, my review name is not like anything you'll actually notice me. Like, it's not my name and it's not my like handles or anything. I think it's just like some like random
Kaiser
name.
Kaiser Sose.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just some random name I decided to use one day. Probably to review us, like just back in the early days. I don't know. Everyone does it. Let's not pretend we don't. But yeah, I've definitely left something. Hopefully it's noticeable. I'll read it out next time when I find it.
But for all of you listeners out there that are looking for another pod or even just another Twitch streamer to check out, these boys are doing, they not only do their podcast live on Twitch, but they do a lot of regular game streaming. They do a retro night. Their podcast is available on all the other the usual podcast outlets as well. But check out A Couple of NPCs.
And they do good shit.
They like, are great dudes.
They just did like a Nuzlocke challenge in Pokemon, which was super fun. And like I love, every time I catch up with Andrew, all we're talking about is fighting games, Street Fighter and Tekken. Good dudes. Great dudes. Really fun to watch. Thanks for the review, guys.
And thank you for the review. For all the other people out there that are not or are leaving reviews, they are, as I say all the time, our lifeblood. They keep the emotional lights on.
So they're coming in thick and fast. I was talking to Reese about this. We should do maybe two next time, two a week even.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just to clear the backlog, because there are a lot of people who left lovely reviews, and we kind of, you know, a lot of small ones too, just like, hey, guys, keep up the good work. Great stuff. Like, lovely reviews. Yeah, let's do that next week. We'll burn through a few.
Definitely, definitely. But yeah, thank you to everyone that does take their time to rate, listen, subscribe, review, whether it be on iTunes, whether you might not have an iPhone and you're using Pocket Cast or Google Play or Stitcher or whatever it is. We're on all those outlets. So just give us a little bit of love on there if you can, because as I said, it doesn't take much time and it means a lot to us. Keeps us relevant, keeps us tracking, keeps happy.
That's it.
And we love you for it.
We do.
We'll shout you a beer when we see you.
Oh, boy. Yeah, sure. Yeah. All right.
not confirming the size or the quality of the beer, but we will shout you a beer.
Yeah.
Maybe it packs.
A shooey. Yeah.
Oh,
we'll shout you a shooey.
I hate that idea. The only person I like doing it is Daniel Ricciardo.
Yeah, who did a shooey. It was in the news this week, I think.
Yeah.
Did a
like shooey. Anyone else except Daniel Ricciardo doing shooeys, you're dumb.
Yeah. That whole ESL... stadium filled with people in Australia earlier this year who did shoeys.
Yeah.
Fantastic. I thought that was great.
Yeah. And I just love the very proper English commentary that sort of was laced over the top of it on the live feed about the shoeys. You need to find it. I don't want to quote it because I just butcher it.
All right. I'll do that.
Check it out on YouTube. It's hilarious.
Mate, what an episode. Just one of the two best. Of us. We can make it if we try. And we did.
I was wondering if you're going to go down that path.
Yeah.
You and I.
That's it. That's it. But of course next week we will be joined again by Reese, and apologies to Reese, I guess we sort of postponed this episode. You and I were not doing too well.
You might
suffering
have food poisoning,
I don't know,
or something?
Dengue fever or something. I was suffering.
It could have been on the back of that apartment you were talking about, that mold. It
might have been.
Maybe you breathed in some mold
God.
particles.
Holy shit. You might be right. I was really not doing so well
right away.
Yeah, and you, of course, you weren't doing so well either.
Yeah.
Nursing a very bad Friday night.
That's
we'll just call it.
Shout out to the beers.
Shout out to the beers.
Yeah.
So sorry, Reese couldn't be here, but he will be back with us next week. And you can find him
at Reese8bit.
At Reese8bit.
Or TurboKerbo _ on the Instagram.
He
loves his Instagrams.
He loves his Instagrams, and he's posting food stuff all the time. He's posting the adventures of Reese Kirby.
He's getting tattooed right now.
He's getting tattooed right now. That's
getting a little banger.
Here.
So he's down in Wollongong. So shout out to the Curbs. Hit us up as a collective at We Are 8bit on all the socials: Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Twitch, Discord, YouTube.com/We Are 8bit for all that tasty video news. 8bit.net for all the written content and links to the video stuff if you don't want to go to YouTube. I can be found at Brendan8bit on just about everything.
That's right.
Where can you be found?
You can find me at Saleem Abraham on the Twitters and probably nowhere else. Don't look for me. Don't look for me.
He's hard to find.
You can find Ali at Miss Ali Hart. Of course, Ali, our beloved friend, is off gallivanting across the states.
She's actually doing some Twitch streaming too.
And she's doing some Twitch streaming. Okay, yeah. So twitch.com.
Twitch.tv/ Clue. You guessed it. Miss Ally Hart.
That's how often I go on Twitch. Yeah, mm-hmm. It's pretty embarrassing actually not to know that. But twitch.tv/Miss Ally Hart.
Be sure to give us some love.
Absolutely.
So that's an episode, you reckon?
I want to do one quick shout out to good friend Yusuf Fade, Yusuf Fadul, who has just become the manager of Jam Gaming's new fighting game team, basically.
Oh, nice.
So they've brought him in. This man does God's work. So this man is a fucking god in Australia.
He's a figurehead in the fighting community.
Absolutely. Like, he just makes sure that everything runs. He runs the Tekken monthlies here. He oversees the Australian Tekken community with a couple other guys, of course. Such a tight community. But he also, I mean, I looked at Injustice 2 the other day. He's, you know, one of the community managers on that whole thing now. Jam Gaming's new fighting,
Which is Just a Minute Gaming.
Just a Minute Gaming, yep. Like, it was just a monthly YSB. It's just a monthly. It happens every month. It's fun, but it's not like, you know, super crazy. But they had two guys. They took the Tekken and the Injustice 2 tournaments there. So anyway, congratulations, Yusuf. Again, you do God's work, mate. Keep it up. Really happy for you with this new move.
One last bit of closing news. We're actually going to do...
just to cut you off, because...
You love doing that.
I love doing that. And if you want to find him, follow him on Twitter, @jam_fade, F-A-Y-D, @jam_fade. Again, the guy, he's all about it. If you're interested in any fighting game stuff, follow this guy. He's the heart of it in Australia. Sorry to interrupt.
Talking about the heart of the fighting scene, I was going to say, you may or may not be at PAX this year. It's still to be confirmed. But we're looking to set up a couple of game tourneys while we're down there. So, Tekken 7.
Yeah.
And Mario Kart 8 Deluxe on the Switch is what we're looking at this stage. More information coming. Also, more information about what we're doing over there. But we're going to have a pretty big presence in conjunction with a couple of friends of ours for PAX Melbourne. So, we're pretty excited. We'll probably unveil that in the next couple of weeks about what we're doing. But get hype. Get keen. Stay hungry.
And I'm pretty sure I'll be there. Like, I'm pretty confirmed to be going down for PAX. And if you want to take a swing at the champ, fucking come.
We're going
to
go
I'm
all
waiting,
out. We're going to get a trophy made.
Because I'll tell you now, like, literally everyone in the sort of the AGPN community, there's not a single person that can really step to me at the moment in Tekken. I know there's a lot of talk, there's a lot of head air, but they're all nobody. They're all nothing.
Pez is the current... champion.
Man, I saw that footage of him play the guy. He literally just beat an employee of Bandai Namco and has somehow decided to claim rank of king. Pez, I'll see you in Melbourne, buddy.
Coming
see
for
you
in
Melbourne,
mate. And I'll see you other Mario Kart people, because I'm useless to Tekken, so I'm not even going to make a claim to the Tekken throne. So, but I'll certainly lay a claim to the Mario Kart throne. We're gonna get trophies. We're going all in. You know, we don't do anything by halves here.
No.
So it's gonna be a time. But check out audiotechnica.com.au for all your audio needs, podcasting, gaming, DJing, the works. It's all there. It's the best stuff. Makes us sound nice. Makes us look nice.
Oh, yeah, the streetwear.
We love our Audio Technica fam, and you will too. Just give them a chance. Until next time, much love.
Stay hungry.
You've been listening to The Hungry Gamers, an exclusive podcast from 8-Bit. Be sure to check out 8bit.net for all your video game and pop culture related needs. Additional Hungry Gamers episodes can be found on Stitcher, SoundCloud, and iTunes. While you're there, please be sure to rate and subscribe. Until next time, boys and girls.